And while Joanne Hardesty is getting ready for this potential meeting with the feds, she's still dealing with a lot of blowback from some false statements that she made last week about the Portland Police Bureau. A quote of hers surfaced last week in Marie Claire magazine, accusing police officers of starting a fire in the Portland Police Union building, which is not true. Hardesty even admitted that it wasn't true and apologized for letting her emotions, she said, get the better of her. But the union, they are not letting her off the hook here. Today, Portland Police Association President Daryl Turner put out an intense statement saying Commissioner Hardesty cannot be trusted and said, I have called for an immediate investigation into Commissioner Hardesty's recent public statements. But our quote of the day didn't actually come until the second paragraph, when Turner said, as police officers, we are held to the highest level of integrity. If we fail to meet those standards, we lose our jobs. And while there are certainly examples of that not being exactly true, that is not what this story is about. It's about Commissioner Hardesty's relationship with Portland Police, which is already very rocky. She's been calling for reforms and oversights for 30 years, and she's going at it again and trying more tomorrow. Tomorrow's City Council is going to take a look at a proposed ordinance from Hardesty that would put a new police oversight agency on the November ballot. It would have greater access to public records. It would be able to speak directly to officers and would be able to investigate fatal incidents. In other words, it would have a whole lot more authority than the city's current system of oversight does right now. Unsurprisingly, the police union, they objected to this, and they put out several reasons why. They say the charter amendment would violate the law. It would create an oversight board that's outside of the city's budgetary rules, and says it was carelessly drafted and didn't have enough input. And today, during a press conference, the Portland City Auditor echoed some of those same concerns.
Commissioner Hardesty has asked us to take her word for it based on her years of experience working on police issues. That's a bold request, given that she wants council to refer an unvetted, unrefined oversight model to the ballot as a charter amendment. It's breathtaking, actually, and not in a good way. This is not normal. Policy should not be based on invitation-only meetings that leave out other ideas than those of the convener. The public should get more than a few days to review the final document and more than a yes-no vote. Expertise should not be kept out of the discussion.
Again, the city will take up Hardesty's proposed ordinance tomorrow. We will keep an eye on how all that goes and, of course, let you know.